Floor. God of hope, give you the fullness of peace, and may the Lord of life be always with you. In the waters of baptism, Jonnie died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon, everyone. And you're all very welcome this afternoon as we gather in sadness to celebrate this Requiem Mass for John McKenna. And for those of you who might be worried that you're at the wrong funeral, it is indeed the funeral of Jonnie Jag, as he was known and loved and celebrated in this community. A very special word of welcome, of course, to his sisters, Violet and Michele, to his brothers, Darren and David, who is joining us this morning from his home in Carlow. And we're praying for him during our Mass today, during this time of sickness for him, that he will experience something of the Lord's healing touch at this time. Welcome as well to Johnny Jag's stepmother, Alice, and to all the members of the Smith and McKenna families. Welcome to all his nephews and all his nieces and his 34 godchildren. Imagine, Johnny must have been the most celebrated godfather of all time. And of course, as we pray for the happy repose of his soul this morning, this afternoon, as we give thanks to God for the gift of his life to his family and to this community and to his community, his native community in Dublin as well. We're remembering his late parents, Tyna and Jim, praying for the happy repose of their souls as well. And as we gather to pray for John this morning, we welcome also the Matthews family who are celebrating today the month's mind of John. And we're joining with the Malloy family, celebrating Thomas, Roseanne and Jim's anniversaries, and the Byrne family celebrating Carmel's anniversary and all the deceased members of the Byrne family. It's also the 7th anniversary of Eileen Coleman and her husband, Michael. So we're praying for and with all of them in our Mass today. But as we come together on this 31st Sunday in Ordinary Time, we take a moment to remember that the Lord is always with us, even at those moments when life fills us with sometimes despair and hopelessness, all those times in our lives when we find it difficult maybe to find hope or to find consolation, to remember that he is here with us in our midst. So let us pray for that openness of heart and mind, that we might be willing and ready to receive him. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us all our sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you give us yourself to heal us, to bring us strength. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on all of us, forgive us all our sins, and bring each of us to life that is everlasting. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. And we sit now as Rachel and Phelan lead us in the liturgy of the word. Is it Rachel and Phelan that are doing the readings? Rachel and Connor.
A reading from the prophet Daniel. At that time, Michael will stand up, the great prince who mount guard over your people. There is going to be a time of great distress, unparalleled since nations first came into existence. When that time comes, your own people will be spared, all those whose names are found written in the book. Of those who lie sleeping in the dust of the earth, many will awake, some to everlasting life, some to shame and everlasting disgrace. The learned will shine as brightly as the vault of heaven, and those who have instructed many in virtue, as bright as stars for all eternity. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, nothing shall. Nothing shall I need.
Reading from the letter to the Hebrews. All the priests stand at their duties every day, offering over and over again the same sacrifices which are quite incapable of taking sins away. Christ, on the other hand, has offered one single sacrifice for his sins and then taken his place forever at the right hand of God, where he is now waiting until his enemies are made into a footstool for high. By virtue of that one single offering, he has achieved the eternal perfection of all whom he is sanctifying. When all sins have been forgiven, there can be no more sin offerings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to his disciples, "In those days, after the time of distress, the sun will be darkened, the moon will lose its brightness, and the stars will come falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. And then too, he will send the angels to gather his chosen from the four winds, from the ends of the world to the ends of heaven." Take the fig tree as a parable. As soon as its twigs grow supple and its leaves come out, you know that summer is near. And so with you. When you see these things happening, you know that the Lord is near, at the very gates. I tell you solemnly, before this generation has passed away, all these things will have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But as for that day or hour, nobody knows it, neither the angels of heaven nor the Son, no one but the Father. The Gospel of the Lord. Who would ever have imagined a couple of years ago that in our own time, in this generation of existence, that we would experience and glimpse something of what the prophet Daniel was talking about in this morning's first reading, or Mark is talking about in the story of today's gospel, the possibility of the annihilation, really, of the whole human race. We've witnessed that fear and what that looks like, at least as a glimpse during these last months. In the liturgy of the church, every year during the month of November, the time when the sun darkens and the moon loses its brightness, as Daniel talks about, we're invited as a Christian people, we're invited to contemplate in this season of autumn coming into winter the stark reality of our own mortality, and to remember that good times, unfortunately, they don't last forever. Nature has that way, hasn't it, of evening things out, drawing us back to understanding the place of suffering and the place of misfortune and even disaster as part of our human condition. Johnny Jag's passing so suddenly and without warning either, apparently even to himself, is another one of those moments of realization. And I suspect that when he went to bed 2 weeks ago, tomorrow evening, the prospect of not opening his eyes to another new day here amongst us had never entered his head, had never crossed his mind. His composure when his remains were found and discovered on Tuesday suggests that life has probably just ebbed away from him, like the tide of the ocean going in and out, and his soul almost sneaked away from him, leaving all those who knew him and all those who loved him devastated and shocked that he's no longer here with us. It's difficult really to countenance, isn't it, how we could ever make sense of that experience of loss without the guiding lights of faith, some hope of a new life beyond the grave, especially when it's taken from us so suddenly and very often without our even realizing. Jonnie, of course, is remembered by all those who knew him and loved him as a man of incredible generosity and a man of incredible kindness, which probably explains why so many parents chose him as a godfather for their children. He had a great love for children. He had a great love for what they represented, and he had a great love for all the hope and the promise that they hold for us. We're jealous sometimes in my generation and beyond, aren't we? We're jealous that sometimes the world is their oyster, and the dreams we have for them that most of us of previous generations could never even have imagined. And Johnny entered into that spirit with all the children that he knew and loved. 34 godchildren, imagine. My God, it was an expensive year for him, year in and year out, wasn't it? Especially when Christmas and birthdays must have come around. And I hope as well he celebrated the moment of their baptism, the realization of their dignity as sons and daughters of God. And he certainly showed them by the way he was generous and kind to all of them, who they were in the sight of God. But what matters more, I think, is that children were drawn to him every bit as much as he was drawn to them, and they felt very much at home in his kindly nature. And we know as well that Johnny had a great love for animals and for the animal kingdom, and especially his beloved, loyal friend, Blue. And he celebrated animals as gift to be enjoyed. But he celebrated them as well as having something very much to teach all of us. Teach us about how we ought to live, especially in our relationships with each other. Because unlike us, animals, by and large, live their lives very often in the most natural way possible, in a way that recognizes their place in the order of things. And very often, unlike ourselves, who can very easily become deluded by power and by things like greed and ambition and selfishness and all those deadly sins, really, that inevitably cause destruction and hardship for ourselves and for others as well, leave us estranged from God's plan. Unlike us, animals live in the rhythm of the natural way and are content, happy to be in the presence of whatever life delivers for them at any given time. And of course we know as well Johnny's love for the cars and the style and the design, especially of his Jag, which brought him great pleasure and delight, a source of, I'm sure, independence, probably giving him a sense of presence, really, in that sense of power that most of us who enjoy cars ourselves, often enjoying. He tuned into the music as well of Leonard Cohen, especially in his listening and in his spirituality. And I hope that listening to that stuff of Leonard Cohen's, he was able to reach his soul in some way or another, his spirituality, that sense of, you know, the other, the realization that this isn't simply it as we see it and as we experience it every day. The big questions that stir from time to time in all of us. Even if sometimes we manage, sometimes, to make our life all the way without ever paying attention to any of that reality. Nonetheless, deep within all of us, whether we choose to acknowledge it or not, there is that wondering and there is that sense of uncertainty, I suppose, about what life really holds for us and whether or not this is it and whether or not there is something more to be enjoyed at the other side of closing our eyes in death. Cohen sometimes meanders in his songs through all those mysteries of life, and he asks huge questions, really, even if he doesn't always give us the answers maybe that we might need to hear. Sometimes those answers have to be found within ourselves. Heaven and coming into eternal life, as we understand it, it isn't about God standing in judgment over us. And it isn't about God determining by the standards of our lives whether we are fit for heaven or not. We're told that in the heavens there is a room already made prepared for every single one of us. For all God that God has made, for every creature that has roamed the earth. Instead, our becoming part of that eternal life that we all yearn for is about my recognizing finally who God is. And it's about being prepared, myself, you and I, being prepared to let go, of all my own grandeur and all my own decidedness, all my self-will and all my freedom even. It's about being willing to be embraced by Him. That's what our faith and the practice of our faith is essentially all about. Training us, teaching us, showing us the importance of learning to let go. Coming into the presence of God hollow. Coming into the presence of God empty. Coming into God's presence with an openness in our minds and in our hearts. Choosing to allow Him to be God and realizing that I am not. So our prayer this morning, this afternoon, for Jonnie and for all who have died indeed, especially at this time of year, this season of the dead, really, in many ways, our prayer this afternoon is that Jonnie will find that grace in his soul, the spirit of today's psalm. And we pray that as he comes into the presence of God, that he will do it fearlessly, that he will do it with that emptiness, with that openness of heart and mind, having shared and shed all that this earthly pilgrimage gathered around him. It's our prayer for all who have died and ourselves as well, especially at this time of year. O Lord, it is you who are my portion and cup. It is you yourself, Lord, who are my prize. I keep the Lord ever in my sight. Since he is at my right hand, I will stand firm. And so my heart rejoices, my soul is glad, even my body will rest in safety. For you will not leave my soul among the dead, nor let your beloved know decay. Instead, you will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence, at your right hand, happiness forever. So let us stand now together with Stephen and Connor and Elaine and Shane and Andrea, praying for Jonnie and praying for each other at this time of mourning and this time of hope.
Dear Lord, thank you for putting John in all our lives and for the joy he brought to all of us. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Dear Lord, John, who was a very special person filled with love, which he shared very generously with us, now that he has gone to you, please fill him with your love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Dear Lord, please give homes to the homeless, food to the hungry, and friends to the friendless. Please give shelter, food, and company to all of your children. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Dear Lord, please take special care of all the bereaved family and friends of John. Please give them the strength necessary to deal with this huge loss. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Dear Lord, we pray for the doctors, nurses, and the carers. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Dear Lord, we pray for all the souls that have nobody to pray for them. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
God, our Heavenly Father, as we pray for John this morning, this afternoon, we remember his late parents, Tyna and Jim, and all the deceased members of the Smith and McKenna families. We pray too for all those whose anniversaries are at this time, remembering especially this afternoon John Matthews, whose month's mind is being celebrated today. Praying for Thomas, Roseanne and Jim Malloy, Carmel Byrne and the deceased members of the Byrne family, and Eileen Coleman and her husband Michael, whose anniversaries are also being celebrated today. We pray for Father Jackie McKeever, native son of the parish, whose funeral will take place here tomorrow at 12 o'clock. And we remember all who died recently among us, especially Nicholas Anderson, Kathleen Daly, Paddy Murphy, Mary Rayburn, Terry Donegan, Sister Catherine Duffy, Patsy Callan, and Olive Monaghan. And your prayers are asked too for David Dollard, who died on Friday in Dundalk and whose funeral will take place in St. Patrick's in Dundalk on Wednesday, and his burial afterwards there as well. Son of Joe Dollard, whose anniversary was celebrated here yesterday evening. For these and all our own deceased relatives and friends, for all those many names that we have enlisted and enrolled on the dead list of our parish, and for all those who died during this past year, we pray eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. Let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Lord, hear us. God, our Heavenly Father, hear the prayers that we have spoken and hear the prayers that we carry in the quiet of our hearts and our minds. Give us the grace to believe and trust that you know our needs even before we ask. We make these and all our prayers in faith through Christ our Lord.
Ave Maria.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, O Lord, we pray that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for all of us the grace of being devoted to you and gain for all of us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and the saints of heaven, we too give you thanks as in exaltation, and together with them we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. And therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread, and he gave it to all his followers, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. John the Baptist, St. John of the Cross, and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Eamon, and Michael, our bishops, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. And in your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Jonnie, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed sisters and brothers too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall become like you forever and praise you for all the ages through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on our lives and on our world everything and all that is good. So let us ask our Father now to forgive us all our own sins and to bring us as well to forgive anyone who might have sinned even against us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us pray for a moment in quiet that Johnny is experiencing that peace that only God can give, and that the fruits of that experience will spill over into our life. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Preserve me, God, I take refuge in you. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let me say the word, my soul. May the body of Christ keep all of us and all those for whom we pray safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep all of us and all those for whom we pray safe for eternal life.
Parting glass.
good night and joy be with you when I am down and my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me.
So we join in prayer with David and with all those who are ill and too vulnerable to be here to celebrate the grace of the sacrament in person and joining us via the webcam. We pray with them and we pray for them. Excuse me. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving
be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us all growth in charity through Christ our Lord. And I invite you now to be seated as Rachel and Derek and Leo lead us in some remembrances of Jackie Jag, Johnny Jag.
For those who don't know me, I'm Rachel, one of John's 34 godchildren, although I called him Jag McKenna, which he loved. He always laughed about that. Still, whenever we spoke, he still called himself that. From speaking to his family the past few days, I just wanted to get a few little pointers just to give you some idea of how John was. It's very hard to kind of get it all down on a few pieces of paper because there's so many lovely memories about him. He was such a kind, loving man and had room in his heart for every woman, man, child and his beloved dogs, most recently Blue. He always made you feel so loved and special. I'll miss our long chats, those big bear hugs, and his infectious hearty laugh. I've so many lovely memories of John. Recently over a phone call, he told me he'd had a teddy he bought me when I was only a kid, but that he kept forgetting to give it to me over the years. So he posted it out to me that week, which is only a few months ago. I can't believe he kept it all of those years. I feel so lucky to have this now, and I'll cherish it forever. John had no fear of anything. He lived with us many years ago, and one night, two men broke into our house whilst we were sleeping. They were armed with knives, and John got up out of his bed, told Mam to go next door to ring for help, and he stayed and fought them off. He actually broke one of their knives in two. You can only imagine they probably realised they'd bitten off more than they could chew, so they left pretty quickly after that, never to be seen again. He was our real-life hero. Going back to his younger years, I was told he was very popular with the ladies. They told me that Michele actually became very popular with the older girls in school because of him. Some of the girls would ask her, could they walk her home after school just so they might get a chance to bump into John. Seemingly, he had velvet suits he used to wear with a satin shirt undone to show off his tanned chest he got working on the building sites. A lot of people used to say he looked like George Best back in the day, which he loved, of course. He always had a love of cars. When he was younger, he was obsessed with having a Triumph Star car and eventually ended up owning one. He then progressed to his beloved Jaguars, amongst others, and eventually opened up his own garage, which my brother's actually worked for him over the years as well. Before I finish up, I have to say a funny story about John, as we all knew him for being such a character. We lived in Spain when I was only a baby, and Mam got to know John from being in the local bar and played Inglés. And of course, Mam being Mam took him under her wing, and that was the start of a lifelong friendship. He was only in his 20s at the time. If he wasn't couch surfing, he'd often sleep on the beach. She'd be given out to him for sleeping there, but he told her he loved it and had the biggest bathroom in the world. He would always come back to her to get fed, though. John loved to socialise, as we know. One night in the local bar called the Irish Jockey, John went in to use the bathroom shortly before closing time, but he ended up falling asleep. No one knew he was in there, and they locked up and went home. When John woke a while after, he came out to an empty bar and it all locked up. Of all the people to lock in your bar. Anyway, anyone else would probably have tried to call for help to get them out of there, but he decided he was going to make the most of it and helped himself to the bar and ended up having a great night. The next morning, the bar owner opened up to find an empty bar and John flat out on the couch in his boxers. He had drank the place dry. Life certainly won't be the same without my Jag McKenna. We all loved him so much and we'll cherish the memories we have of him. Sleep well, Jag McKenna, aka Jonnie Jags.
Afternoon. How do you follow that? My name is Derek, aka Fingers. And when Tara asked me in the week would I like to say a few words, of course I said, yeah, I'd love to. For Johnny. What do you say about Johnny? I look at all the faces here and I know everybody has funny stories. Tara said, maybe you tell a funny story. I said, no, you don't want to hear half of my funny stories with Johnny. But I thought about it and one thing I wanted to home on, and it's been touched on already, the relationship Johnny had with people, and especially the younger people in his family, vicinity, friends and whatnot, and especially Rachel. And Rachel, I just want to say, he talked about your wedding next year a lot. I was meant to go with him. He bought shirts for it 5 weeks ago. We were in the market and fairy house for your wedding. And anyway, but the some things I didn't know what am I going to do. I don't want to tell a funny story, but some things, like Johnny put on a big brave persona, a big tough guy, but he was really a teddy bear, as we know. He'd give you anything, he'd do anything for me. I know that much. But when it came to kids, he had really a special soft spot, you know. And it got me thinking. I said, look, I'll talk about Johnny himself, you know, the true essence of Johnny McKenna. And in that, I'll tell you about a thing. We buried Johnny's dad 6 months ago. And after that, we again had this conversation about life and death and how it comes to us all. And we tend to, we know it's there, but we push it away. And then when it hits us, we're devastated and don't know what to do and how to handle it. And yet, we know it's inevitable. But we had this conversation over and over again. And we came to the conclusion that the true essence of who we actually are is love. And how we treat each other, how we are with each other, especially with little ones, and more, and beyond. And we truly believe that we're only passing through here, and there is another side to all of our lives, and that's our next life. However you might see it, or feel it, or whatever. But this was such conversations that we've recently had, well, we've had them for years, but most recently when Jem died. And you may or may not think it, but Johnny had a very true, real, spiritual side to him, very in-depth. And I'm sure many of you had this kind of similar conversation, but it's something I thought I'd mention. But I will tell you one quick, funny story, if I may. And it's going back, I believe it was 1998, maybe 89, before I was married anyway. And we had a little day off work, and we were down Strawberry Hall on strawberry beds having one or two. And he told me about the jumping church over near where he lives. And for the dubs who are here wouldn't know about it, jumping church, the wall of the church in the storm blew off and landed upright some 4 feet away from where it was found that the foundations were. And I said, I'd love to see that. Right, come on, into the car, and away with him up the road. And at 1 o'clock in the morning, we're going down to this graveyard, and it was raining. So he had shopping in the back with these lace curtains, white lace. I said, here, Fingers, throw that over your head. And we're going around with these white curtains over our head, because it was raining. 1 o'clock in the morning, and a great laugh. And it was very interesting. He proceeded to bring me to, I believe, his uncle Tommy and Betty, am I right in saying? Who lived on the inner road, he called it. I just can't knock into them at this hour. I'd be up, grand, grand. Of course, they were still up, but we were brought in, corned beef sandwiches, cups of tea, 10 bottles of milk, and the whiskey came out. But we had a great night. But that was one fond memory, well, one of many, and I'm looking at everyone here, and we all have our own funny stories regarding Johnny and Jake. I'll never forget that particular one. We ended up back in the maggot running around the graveyard and all. Like, if anyone saw us, they think we were spooks. But he was never one without a story, and always ready for a story and a joke. And that's how I remember Johnny Jack. He was a big guy in my eyes. I know everyone's going to miss him. I certainly will. And that's as much as I want to say about my friend right now. And thank you. Good morning.
So before we go our separate ways, let us take leave now of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May these our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. So let us pray in silence for the happy repose of his soul. Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Grant him eternal rest, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of John, your servant, in the sight of this world. He is now dead, but in your sight may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he may have committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, Lord, grant him everlasting rest and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. And let us now in peace take our brother to his place of rest.
Now I've heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this. You say I took the name in vain. I don't even know the name. But if I did, well, really, what's it to you? There's a blaze of light in every word. It doesn't matter what you heard. The holy or the broken, hallelujah. 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 I did my best, it wasn't much. I couldn't feel, so I tried to touch. I've told the truth, I didn't come to fool you. And even though it all went wrong, I'll stand before song with nothing on my tongue but hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
I hate it, sorry. Yeah.